We are 15 minutes away from a national champion or national champions. There will be no playoff. Here are the statistics through three.
Very similar to the first half statistics. Miami still with the edge in total yardage and maintaining about a six-minute time of possession lead. But Penn State tried to run the football more in the third quarter. Got a little bit more successful, but as you see yards rushing, just 93 for the Nittany Lions, down from their normal output through the year.
And a first down for Miami from the 46, Testaverde to throw. It is intercepted by Gatopoulos. To the 45, to the 40, and down at the 36-yard line. Darrell Oliver made the tackle 24 yards on the return. Four turnovers by Miami. Three interceptions.
Let's take a look at it from the secondary. You see the deep zone one more time. Shane Collin in the middle of the field. It's another unusual wrinkle on the part of the Penn State defense. A confused Testaverde one more time. And it's Giftopoulos with the interception, his second of the night. And he puts the Penn State offense in good position.
At the 36-yard line, first down, Miami territory. DJ Dozier, and he goes out of bounds. It'll be second down.
Joe Paterno has made the Penn State football tradition out of defense through the years. That's the way he's gone the entire way. You're not going to see a lot of flashy things on the part of the offense. And people talk about his uniforms and his style of play going in sync with the way that he performs on the football field. But it is all defense. It is not a flashy offense. You're not going to see many reverses on the part of the Nittany Lions.
Second down and seven. Hamilton in motion. Steve Smith, and we'll give him a yard to the 32. It's going to be third down and six. Jerome Brown was there. Let me make a correction. Giftopoulos has an interception. Duffy Cobbs has an interception. Shane Conlon has the interception. Those are the three interceptions, and Duffy Cobbs also has a fumble recovery for the Canes. Winston Moss with a fumble recovery. Selwyn Brown has an interception. Bill Hawkins has an interception. That's all the turnovers. Let me just update that for us. At the 32, third down and six. Schaefer with pressure and is knocked away. And it will be fourth down, so the Nittany Lions unable to capitalize on the turnover, and Massimo Manca comes in. His career long is 53 yards. This last season, he hit from 49, and he has hit 8 of his last 11. And this one will be from 50 yards away to take the lead for the first time. Kisner to hold, and Greg Truitt is the snapper. That's way short. So Massimo misses from 50, and we remain tied at 7-7, and we have 14 minutes and 1 second left in this national championship battle.
Have you ever watched people at the market? They all think they know how to pick the best orange.
They squeeze. They tap. They shake. I have no idea what she's doing.
But all they have to do is twist the wrist. If it says Sunkiss, you pick it. Hey, always read the label.
There's a tendency in business to focus on the big picture. But at Cigna, we realize the big picture is actually made up of millions of smaller pictures, which is why our companies provide an array of insurance, healthcare, employee benefits, and financial services to millions of individuals and thousands of businesses. One person at a time. Cigna. Personalized service to business around the world.
Sunkissed Fiesta Bowl, the national championship, is brought to you by the Sunkissed family of products. The Sunkissed name means quality. You have our word on it. By General Electric. At GE, we bring good things to life. And by Cigna, a leader in insurance, healthcare, employee benefits, and financial services.
This is Charlie Jones along with Jimmy Cefalo and Bob Greasy. Miami with the ball at their own 33, taking over at the line of scrimmage after the missed field goal. And here's Melvin Bratton. Shoots to the right side. And once again, the defense is there. And Bob Greasy, we were talking about this during the timeout. It has been a defensive ballgame.
It's a defensive game, Charlie. Neither team looking that good on offense. You know, it's almost fitting. This is a national championship game. And you say, you win championships with your defense. The offense sells the tickets, but the defense wins the championships, and that's what you're seeing here tonight.
So you don't think we're seeing a sloppy offensive game, that the defenses are just dominating both sides?
I think you're seeing a sloppy offensive game because of the defense.
Okay, all right. Second and 11, Testaverde to throw over the middle. Here's Bratton. And he's out to the 44, maybe the 45-yard line. And he's got the first down. Bauer with the tackle and a gain of 12 yards on the play.
And the running backs, Melvin Bratton and Alonzo Highsmith, are playing a more important factor as we go down through the fourth quarter, because the Penn State deep zones are taking it away, the deep passing game of Vinny Testaverde. There you see a comparison. Schaefer just 4 of 14. Testaverde just under 50%.
And a 200-yard difference. Down at the Penn State 48-yard line. Eddie Johnson was the man who hit him.
By number 90, Pete Gonzalez, and number 39, Eddie Johnson.
And it's going to be second down and a couple after he picks up 8 yards on the play. And I'm wondering now if the Canes are going to stay on the ground. They have a great running attack. You know, their rushers average, you know, 4.2, 5.8, you know, high numbers. As far as rushing yardage is concerned, they'll go to the rushing attack and then they get away from it. Maybe they'll stay with it here. As Highsmith slips, he may break clean. He's to the 30 and goes to the 27-yard line. 19 yards. Check that, 21 yards. Isom and Henderson finally ride him down.
And who else to go to in this situation but Alonzo Highsmith? You want to know who Vinny Testaverde's vote for the Heisman Trophy was? That man sitting on the ground with a leg cramp, Alonzo Highsmith. He thinks he's the best football player in the country, and he shows you why on that run.
And Highsmith this past season averaging 4.2 yards a carry and averaging 13.9 yards a reception. So it has been the rushing attack now sparking the Canes. We've got a timeout. We are tied at 7-7. We'll be back to the championship battle in just a moment.
To know no boundaries, to let yourself run.
Investment opportunities. Merrill Lynch is there with the help you need to make the most of them. Because at Merrill Lynch, we believe your world should know no boundaries.
To know no boundaries.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Just for the fun of it. Just for the smile of it. Diet Coke. Just for the cool of it.
Smith has rushed now for 92 yards. We still have 12 minutes to go in the ballgame. And Penn State did not allow 100 yards rushing. The most was Paul Palmer of Temple. He had 96. Bob?
Gary Stevens, the offensive coordinator for Miami, says, we've got a good rushing attack, but we hate to stay with it too long because he's taking the ball out of Testaverde's hands. Well, they may win the championship with a running game.
And here's Bratton, and he is pushed out of bounds.
Gary number 5, Melvin Bratton.
Don Graham bumped him out. It would be pretty hard to take the ball out of Testaverde's hands, but perhaps in this case you have to.
Well, when you take a look at the entire Miami offense, they're skilled people. You've got a bunch of first-round draft choice. Obviously, Testaverde. Melvin Bratton, we mentioned earlier, will be one when he graduates. Alonzo Highsmith is the best fullback in the country coming into the draft this year. So who do you give the football to? There's only one ball. If you could cut it up in four or five spots, Miami would have a heck of a deal.
And you'd have had more receptions when you were playing,
guys. No, I wouldn't.
Second and nine at the 27. Now they'll throw. Is Testaverde rolling? And it is pulled down. No. He did not get the 1 foot inbound. Ryan Blades, the intended receiver. Now, Testaverde going to his left. Not a lot of people realize this, but Testaverde, right-handed, he throws, he bats, and he shoots a bow and arrow.
He shoots a bow and arrow left-handed?
Right-handed. Left-handed, he writes, signs autographs, left-handed. He eats left-handed, and he shoots a gun left-handed.
And that is an incredible catch by Blades on the corner. Indeed, 1 foot down in college ball, of course, just outside of the boundary.
So it's not hard for Testaverde to go to his left or his right. They're down and nine. Pass is complete to Bratton, and Bratton is down at the 21-yard line, so he'll have about six on the play. And it's going to be fourth down and three. Now, do you go with a field goal attempt? First half of the ball game.
You betcha you do.
Similar situation with the first down.
National championship football game, 21 yards at 7, 28 yards. You got to go for the field goal and take the lead. The Miami defense has done a good job, and it's in the hands right now, or at least the foot of Mark Seelig.
From 38 yards away, and Seelig, remember, missed from 28 yards. This is from 38 yards. And it is good. From 38 yards away. And Miami leads for the second time in the ballgame. The score, the Canes 10, the Nittany Lions 7. We'll be back with a kickoff.
I don't know. What are you going to do?
I don't know.
I'd go to college.
Me too.
If I had the money.
Yeah.
So what are you going to do?
I don't know. What are you going to do?
You don't want those fries.
What are you going to do, Jack? Eat your way to college?
Really? I'm going to college on the new GI Bill. You serve full-time in the armed forces or part-time in the reserves, and you earn a lot of money for tuition.
The new GI Bill.
Are you using that pickle?
Now for young men and women in the armed forces, it's a great place to start. See your local recruiter.
I don't know. You can't drive at night anymore. Did you know that? Mom told me that. I mean, that's really nothing.
I know.
I mean, 5 years, 7 years from now, what happens then? He won't ask us. Even if he needs our help, he won't ask us. So we've got to do something. We're the ones, you know.
Mark Seelig with the successful field goal. An important moment in his life, not only for the 3 points.
Not just for the 3 points. He puts Miami up in the national championship football game, but Mark Seelig has dedicated this football game to his father, who died about 10 years ago. And when asked why he never spoke about this before, he said, well, I never thought it'd be a significant part in maybe winning a game. And here it is, a national championship game, maybe looking up and saying, hey, that one was for you, Dad.
Miami 10, Penn State 7, and the reaction of Joe Paterno. He's saying, let's go, let's get it back. All right, let's see if they can. Coates and Thomas are the deep backs. Coates is 49 on the right, Blair Thomas is 32 on the left. 11 minutes and 49 seconds left to go for the national title, and Miami is up by 3. Thomas at the 8-yard line to the 20, and he just scrambles out to about the 28-yard line. So we'll give him 20 yards on the return, and Penn State goes to work in their own territory.
And now we find out what kind of a winner John Schaefer was. We mentioned 65-1 since the seventh grade. You know, they said about him in the past, he doesn't throw very well, he doesn't run very well, but he does win football games. Those same words were first used by Rip Engel, the head coach at Brown, when he was describing a skinny little scrawny left-handed quarterback by the name of Joe Paterno.
And we have on the ground, that's Quintus McDonald, who is down with a leg cramp. And so the clock is stopped with 11:44 left to go. We'll take an injury timeout. The Canes leading the Nittany Lions by 3, 10-7.
She went home with a stranger. She woke up to a murder.
What did I do?
Why don't I remember any of this?
Now, the only ones who can help her are the last people she should trust.
Who's want to set me up?
You killed that man!
Jane Fonda, Jeff Bridges, The Morning After. Can Be Murder. Rated R. Now playing. Check newspapers for theaters.
All I had was a salad and a little dressing to make it taste good. That's hardly any calories.
I only had broiled fish for lunch. That's not fattening.
Just broccoli with a little butter. It's nothing.
Hey, if you're going to eat light, then do it right with a squeeze of fresh sun-kissed lemon. You get a lot of flavor, not a lot of calories. Sun-kissed lemon. You can count on it for flavor. You have our word on it.
All right. The injured player now being taken off. We'll get back to that story in just a moment. But first, a very good defensive ball game, a little sloppy offensively. How does Penn State get back into it, Jimmy?
Well, I think they got to get the football into the hands of D.J. Dozier. I said earlier in the telecast that he's got to touch the ball 20 or so times a football game, but he seems to have been non-existent lately, at least in the last couple of minutes. I think he has to carry the football for them to get back into it.
Bob, what about their passing game?
Only 3 points behind. I think Schaefer is in a good situation. He's got to play it from strength. Don't play outside of yourself. Stay within yourself. Do the things that you do best. Get the running game going, the short passing. Only 3 points down. They can get out and tie it or get a touchdown to go ahead and win.
And there's still a lot of time. All right, we have 11 minutes and 44 seconds. And a first down. And here is Dozier. He stumbles a bit as he makes his move. Penn State averaging only 3 yards per play tonight on offense. And that, of course, is a credit also to the Canes defense. Hurricane defense has really played well.
Oh, yeah, they've got a lot of players back there as well. Benny Blades. Now, here's a player, All-American consensus. We haven't talked about a lot tonight, but that's because Joe Paterno said we've got to stay away from Benny Blades if we want to win the football game. Seems like they've been doing it all night long.
Second down, Schaefer to throw. There's pressure, and he's sacked. 5 sacks. And Rod Carter and Jerome Brown team up for this one. Woo!
Brown and Carter coming from the same side. They said earlier they've got a double team. Brown, are they trying to? He's just bullying his way through. And then from the backside, that's Rod Carter with a big sack. Hey, it's tough when you've got people. And salute. All right, Jerome. They came in dressed in battle fatigues, and they're that ready. Was a salute to the captain on the sideline.
Third down and 18. And here's Dozier. Dozier to the 30. Dozier to the 35. And he's going to be about 4 yards shy of the first down. Sheldon Brown with the tackle. He picks up 13. He needed 18. And that means that John Bruno will come in to punt. Dozier now has rushed for 91 yards. 10 minutes exactly left to go. It'll be Bruno to David Kintyre. There's pressure every time coming from Bubba McDowell. And here's Kintyre to the 20, and he'll be wrapped up at the 21-yard line. 48-yard kick, a 5-yard return. And Kurt Bernier is the man who was down. As we pause briefly for station identification, this is the NBC Television Network.
This is KYW-TV, Channel 3 in Philadelphia.
3rd and 4 yards on the play.
This is Charlie Jones along with Jimmy Cephalo and Bob Greasy in the national championship game, the battle for number one, where we have 9 minutes and 37 seconds left. The University of Miami leading Penn State 10-7, and the Canes have the ball. And here's Melvin Bratton. And Bratton goes to the 34-yard line. So he picks up 13 yards in the first down. Don Graham makes the tackle.
Melvin Bratton runs like a little bumblebee. He's got good size, not a great blocker, but he can really buzz around the defense. We mentioned earlier that Highsmith is coming up to 100-yard rushing against the Penn State defense that has not done it this year. Well, Highsmith has not had 100 yards. The only one for Miami to do it has been Melvin Bratton.
And here is Bratton. And this time he'll lose a step. They're going to mark at the line of scrimmage. So it'll be second down and 10 as Trey Bauer makes the tackle.
Okay.
Now we're moving on the 9-minute mark, and early on everyone expected that Penn State wanted to use up the clock. Now the Canes with the lead, albeit 3 points, 10-7. They could be content with running some time down. Second down. Testaverde with both backs into block, throws, and it is intercepted. Conlon to the five. For Penn State, 2 for Conlon, 38 yards on the return, 5-yard line, first down, goal to go with a national championship in the balance.
Remember when you were a kid growing up, you dreamt about things like maybe playing in a national championship football game. Fourth quarter, you're down by 3 points, you make a big interception. That's exactly what Shane Conlon did, and his dreams of his youth may come true tonight.
From the power eye, a scramble for the ball. There was a misconnection on the snap. And it will be second down, goal to go. Keith Radicek, the center, senior from Pittsburgh. His brother Scott, a linebacker with Kansas City.
He just doesn't get the ball, or maybe he's starting to pull out a little bit too. What happens is the center starts his block before the center gets the ball. Obviously, it's not a smooth snap, but the center has got to snap the ball first and then get to his block.
And Penn State wants a timeout to talk it over. We'll be back in just a moment.
Wait till you see the changes we're making at Howard Johnson.
This is Howard Johnson?
This is Howard Johnson?
This is Howard Johnson.
If you haven't stayed with us recently, you may be in for a surprise.
This is Howard Johnson.
We're changing our rooms, our furnishings, and there's a new attention to service.
This is Howard Johnson.
This is Howard Johnson.
This is Howard Johnson.
Those of you with small children or grandchildren, forget about the toys, teddy bears, and tricycles. Let's talk about things to come. Doctors, lawyers, teachers. Your child's future begins with education, and education begins with funding. E.F. Hutton has many ways to help you prepare for the future and the funding. It's never too soon to start, so why wait? Start now. I have E.F. Hutton because it's my money.
Let's go back to that last interception. Conlon and another linebacker are lined up here. The tight end's going to run straight up the field. Now watch as Conlon and the other linebacker go straight back. And Conlon says, "You're in my way. Scoot over there." And it's as if Testaverde saw the inside linebacker, but not Conlon. Tried to throw it over his head and was picked off by Conlon for the second time today.
And Trey Bauer, the inside linebacker, who then came up and was doing the congratulations. And the ball now at the 6-yard line after the miscue on the snap. Second down, goal to go. Testaverde sitting on the sideline. Manoa and Dozier, the running back. And Here's Dozier. Dozier scores! And 13 seconds left in the ball game, and now the extra point attempt. Massimo Manco, and it is good. Penn State 14, Miami 10.
The replay for the score. Dozier takes it wide and cuts back. Nice block by Keith Radisic, number 56, the center, in for the score and a Penn State lead.
And it is set up by the Penn State defense and is set up by a Penn State linebacker, Shane Conlon, with the interception. 5 yards on the drive in two plays. And the score coming from 6 yards out, of course, the fumble, the loss of a yard. And it's 14-10, but a lot of time for the Canes. 8 minutes and 13 seconds, and they have the arm of Vinny Testaverde, and he has not been playing that well thus far. But can he do it? Here's another look at DJ Dozier. DJ, a very religious young man. In fact, when we were shooting the headshots of all the players on Sunday, he was with a group of five, the last ones to be shot because he came back from church.
And that's exactly, he wasn't tired at the end. He was kneeling down in prayer, and it's a ritual that he goes through after every touchdown.
Only the second man in Penn State history, as you saw, to rush for more than 3,000 yards. And Massimo Manca to kick off. And Bratton is the deep back. And this is down in the end zone for the touchback. We'll bring it out to the 20-yard line.
Charlie, there's no question that at this point in time, Vinny Testaverde is frustrated and confused. Now, the teams exchanged all 11 game films for this year, but the one that Joe Paterno wanted was last year's Sugar Bowl. He called Johnny Majors at Tennessee, and Tennessee beat the University of Miami 35-7. Johnny Majors was at Pittsburgh, but Johnson says, no, I can't do it. Get back to it in just a second.
Okay. And here's Alonzo Highsmith to the 25, the 30. 35, he's to the 40, and down at the 42-yard line, it was Duffy Cobbs who saved the day, or he could well have scored.
And apparently Alonzo Highsmith had that same dream as a young man about being the hero of a national championship football game. Again, the linebacker playing fullback, refusing to go down, running over people. Ray Isom, he runs over one time. Another defender, he still refuses to fall on the ground.
And Alonzo 114 yards rushing in 16 carries, 42-yard line, first down. And here he comes again. And he has 4 yards to the 46. Second down and six. Let's go back to your story, Bob.
In last year's Sugar Bowl game, Testaverde threw three interceptions, was sacked 8 times, and Paterno called Majors for the film, and Johnny Majors says, no, I know Jimmy Johnson. And Paterno turned to his assistant and says, I want that film. Just get it. I don't know. I don't care how you get it. And Paterno told us the other day, said, well, we got it, but I don't know where we got it from.
Melvin Bratton up to his feet, maybe just a little leg cramp.
That was the worst game that Testaverde has had in his career up until this point. He is not playing well tonight, and it's because, I think, that Penn State is doing several different things and has confused him and frustrated him, taking away those big plays.
Well, you made the statement earlier that Joe Paterno wanted to get inside of his head and cause a little confusion. You know, as a quarterback, that can be deadly if they can do it. And here's Testaverde to throw. Let's see if he can come back, and he does as he goes to Alfredo Roberts, his tight end. With 7 minutes minutes and 12 seconds left for the title. From Paramus, New Jersey, what's number 35?
From the reverse angle, this time Testaverde wanted to go downfield to Michael Irvin, but he was being covered by Shane Conlon. And there's the fumble on the part of Alfredo Roberts, clearly on his way down. Trey Bauer making sure, number 35, that he doesn't get anywhere near that fumble.
The ball at the Miami 49-yard line and a first down for Penn State. And now Schaefer steps away, and the Nittany Lions stop the clock with 7 minutes and 12 seconds left. They lead 14 to 10, and we'll be back in just a moment to the Sunkissed Fiesta Bowl.
You flying on to Chicago?
I'm on the 10 o'clock American flight. The meeting's this afternoon.
Then?
Then an early morning flight to Nashville and home to the coast tomorrow evening.
Seems like you're busier than ever.
Your mother knows how to reach me if you need me.
Dad? I'm glad you could stop by.
I wish I had more time. Now, when did you say you were planning on coming home again?
Not until the end of the term.
Well, you know, I don't think I can wait that long.
Something special. People know it. American Airlines. Something special in the air.
This is Charlie Jones with Jimmy Cefalo and Bob Greasy. We're at the Sunkissed Fiesta Bowl. This is the 16th edition. Sun Devil Stadium, Tempe, Arizona. The temperature dropping down in the 40s.
And Alfredo Roberts clearly upset about the fumble after the reception, and that's clearly understandable. You know, big, tough football players, but you get in this situation, and they're all human, and Alfredo Roberts feeling it now.
Dozier back to the line of scrimmage. And it'll be second down and 10.
Brought down by...
We've talked about the miscues of Miami. Here they are, 6 turnovers, 1 missed field goal, 5 drop passes. They allowed 3 sacks, penalized 8 times. And they trail by 4, 14 to 10. And, of course, that's just one play away from the arm of Vinny Testaverde. Don't forget that. And it is second down and 10. And Schaefer to throw. His pass is complete at the 43-yard line to Brian Seiberling, the tight end, who is a member of the National Football Foundation Scholar Athlete, was named as one. George Meyer Jr. there for the defense, 43-yard line. Gain of 6, third down and 4, and the clock ticks away.
And Alfredo Roberts getting the condolences of his teammates, saying, keep your head up, hey, and you're right, Charlie. One pass by Vinny Testaverde gets this football game right back and a national championship as well.
And here is Schaefer with pressure. He throws and is knocked away. He was going to Ray Roundtree, and Don Ellis made the defensive play. And once again, the balance could well hang on the foot of John Bruno, who has had an excellent evening kicking, particularly early in the ball game. He really kept the Nittany Lions in the game. And David Kintai is set for the return. This is the 8th punt for John Bruno. Caught it down, and it gets away, slipping out of the grasp. 43 yards on the kick. Of course, he could have caught it if he could have run under it. But just, Sherrod Reigns just simply could not get there in time. The ball goes into the end zone for the touchback. We'll bring it out to the 20-yard line. Well, the playoffs, the Jets and the Browns, as tomorrow at 12 Eastern time. The big question is, who do you like? So Jimmy Cefalo, who do you like? It puts you on the spot.
I like the Cleveland Browns. I mean, how can you not? We're talking about Bernie Kosar, and this is one of the other great Miami quarterbacks. I like Kosar in that football game.
He goes right back to Alfredo Roberts. The pass is complete. A flag is down. I like that call. He came back looking for Roberts, and he passes right to him and puts him right back in the ball game. And we had markers on the play. And here's the call. Offensive pass interference. So Miami continues to self-destruct as they take the ball back to the 10.
Charlie, you're right about going right back to Alfredo Roberts. It can be deadly to the psyche of a receiver. You drop a pass, you make a big mistake, and if you don't get the football back again, you may never want it the rest of the football game. And it's a real tribute to Alfredo Roberts to go back and say, hey, Benny, you throw me the football. I got one the last time I dropped it. I won't drop it again. And he did.
Offensive pass interference, 10 yards, and the loss of down back to the 10. So it is second down and 20. And on the draw, here's Heisman. No game. It's going to be third down and 20.
Charlie, the confidence of the Miami offense has got to be shaken at this point. Four interceptions, two fumbles. They've turned the ball over six times. It's almost as if, you know, what's going to happen next? I can guarantee you that Testaverde is short-arming the ball a little bit, making sure that he sees all the defensive players before he throws the football.
What do you mean by short-arming?
Well, he's not really firing it. He's making sure. He's a little hesitant, a little tentative.
Goes deep, and it is incomplete. Two receivers in the same area. Urban was there, and Alfredo Roberts was also there. As was Marcus Henderson, the defensive back for Penn State. Here's another look.
All right, Alfredo Roberts the entire way. That's Shane Collin, number 31, trying to cover him down the middle of the field. It's a zone. Michael Urban and Roberts in the same area, but you know he's going after it all the way. Alfredo Roberts wanting to make up for the drop ball, and no lack of effort, certainly not at all, by Alfredo Roberts.
He goes with the kick, takes the Miami roll, then taken on the second hop by Jim Coach. He'll get a couple of yards on the return, 4 yards on the return, a 49-yard kick, and J.C. Finney was down very quickly on the coverage team. We haven't seen J.C. as a return man since early in the ballgame. And now Penn State has the ball, 4:56, time remaining. Penn State leads 14-10. At their own 43-yard line, first down. No hurricanes inside, but Lions are everywhere. Well, that's the Fiesta forecast. Penn State number one, don't celebrate too soon. 4:56, that is the time remaining. And on the reverse is Ray Roundtree. And Roundtree to about the 46-yard line. He ran that reverse eight times during this past season. And Testaverde on the phone with the coaches upstairs.
Bob, you think an unusual call? You come down, you have not run a reverse all year. It is not a major part of your offense. There's 4 minutes and 28 seconds left in the football game. You got to control it. Is that a surprise to you?
I think it was Paterno's way of getting a big play into his offense. I think that he thought that Miami was not expecting it, and that was a way to maybe surprise him a little bit. He's done that before this season.
And, of course, Roundtree made a point to stay in bounds and work some time off of the clock. And here's Dozier. They have a couple of yards to the 48-yard line. And it's going to be third down and 5. Jimmy Johnson, the head coach of the Canes.
There's plenty of time on the clock for the University of Miami. They don't have to start using timeouts yet. Interesting situation for Penn State. Do you throw the football? Third down, 5 yards to go. You got to control the ball. I think you throw it. What do you say, Bob?
You go with what got you here, and I think that's the run, Jimmy.
Third and 5.
Yeah, that's why I'm you're the quarterback.
Manoa and Dan Cilio drops him for a loss of 2. And we've got a timeout taken by Miami. Miami now with 2 timeouts left. Penn State has 1. We'll be back in a moment.
Kleber, did you send those galoshes to Cleveland? They didn't get there.
Yes, Mr. Reliable, Air Express.
Which company did you use?
Why? Aren't they all the same?
Hold it. If you'd used Federal Express, you wouldn't be having this problem. Come with me. You see, Federal Express isn't the same as everybody else because today it takes much more. For instance, we have computers in our vans.
Oh!
so our couriers know instantly when there's a pickup.
I see.
And at our stations, we track every package and can tell you its exact status within 30 minutes or your money back.
Is that right?
And we have the most advanced communication system in the business.
I see.
So we can give you the information you need quickly. This makes us more reliable.
We see.
Next time, send it Federal Express, because all Air Express companies are not the same.
Reliable. I like that, an Air Express company.
Yes, Mr. Reliable.
Admiral Waverly Wheeler. 3 minutes and 18 seconds left. Miami, two timeouts. Penn State, one timeout. And Miami now will have an opportunity as John Bruno will be kicking to David Kintyre. Watch for number 48, Bubba McDowell of the Canes. He's on the far side, and he has been close to blocking a punt. And here he comes, and he doesn't get there. And Kintyre on the return. And he's down around the 22-yard line. 40 yards on the kick, a 7-yard return. Vernier again there for Penn State. And the award-winning season, Heisman Trophy, Maxwell Trophy, Davey O'Brien, Walter Camp, Consensus All-American, TD Club College Athlete of the Year, Touchdown Club College Athlete of the Year. And now time is running out to be number one. So let's see what he can do from his own 23-yard line. He has pressure. Fights his way out to the 27-yard line. He scrambles for four, and his second down is six. Trey Bauer with the tackle, and the clock continues to move.
Charlie, Penn State has played the Heisman Trophy winner three of the last 5 years and beaten him all three times. So Testaverde, not by himself and not doing so well on New Year's Day, or January 2nd this year against Penn State.
It is second and six. Intercepted by Trey Bauer. In and out of his arm. .231 left.
Charlie, as good as Testaverde is, and as many of awards as he has won, his confidence now is a little bit shaken. He sees linebackers coming when he doesn't see them. He could come from nowhere. They're almost picking off his passes. He is the man that has to bring him down to win the national championship, and their leader is shaken.
Third down and six, three wide receivers, 2.5 minutes to go, trailing by four. Has time, and he goes deep to Bratton. Does he get it? No. He throws it inside, and he had to come back for it. Marcus Henderson has the coverage. Do you take a big gamble now with 2:24 left?
I don't think so. Miami has two timeouts left. Their defense has been playing fairly well. I think you kick it away and try to come back and give it to Vinny Testaverde with a little time left. He's got the arm that can get you a touchdown and a national championship in one series.
They're going to go with it, though.
If you go for it here, Charlie, the whole game is on the line right here. If you miss it, it's over.
Here it is for the title. Seconds on the 25-second clock. It's there. First down to Brian Blade. Blade's down the sideline all the way to the Penn State 41-yard line. 32 yards. It was fourth and six. Marcus Henderson finally got him. Prior to that play in the second half, Testaverde only 7 of 18, 57 yards, 3 touchdowns, but there he is, just one throw away.
Hey, and it tells you something about the Heisman Trophy winner. He wasn't ready to give it up yet. Yeah, they went for it at fourth down, and look at Blades dancing down the sideline. Finally pushed out. A big play by both Blades and Testaverde.
Far side, pass is there. And it is Blades again. Duffy Cobbs makes the tackle. Clock move. There's not a two-minute warning in college ball. It'll just keep on moving. 35-yard line. Second down. Second and three. As time, he throws. It is there. time, Brent Perryman. Close to the 25-yard line. And we'll stop the clock. Eddie Johnson making the stop for the Nittany Lions. They stop the clock for the first down. And the clock will start when the ball is ready for play. It's at the 26. Miami still with two timeouts. Penn State with one. Over the middle. Irvin slips. It goes down at the 22. Has four. Second down and six.
Three times in a row, Testaverde went to that quick out to the outside. Penn State seemed content to give it up. They've been doing it all night. Why change now? That time, he goes to Michael Irvin, the playmaker. He's the one you want to go to when it's in the clutch.
Testaverde. Irvin at the 10. A gain of 12. Not taking the timeout. That's for the first down. The clock being stopped in college ball.
It shouldn't end any other way, Charlie.
That's the way
top offensive team gets a good defensive team playing for the national championship in the last minute of the season.
And the man voted the best player in the country is the one directing him down. You know, let's talk about Vinny Testaverde. Down here, fourth and six, not completing a lot of passes. He's got the guts to stand up and get the first down and lead him down the field. Tells you a lot about that young man.
It came down to one play, and he did it. At the 27-yard line, Shane Conlon, the injured player. Fourth down and six back at the 27-yard line. And Testaverde did it.
Well,
he has hit five consecutive completions.
Well, he has. And as Jimmy pointed out, he's throwing to the outside, Charlie, on the corners who are playing one-on-one on the wide receivers. When he's gotten in trouble, he's thrown the ball to the middle of the field and linebackers that he did not see have picked the ball off. Great strategy on the part of Penn State to hide Conlon inside, do some different things with their linebackers. But the weakness of that defense, Testaverde has found, is on the outside throwing those quick outs.
Don't forget Brian Blades. He caught that pass on fourth and six. It takes two to make the first down. And a big play. Testaverde throws. It is complete at the five-yard line to Michael Irvin. Henderson wrestles him down at the five. It'll be second down goal to go. The score, 14 to 10. Forget about the field goal. The margin is four. By the way, Brian Blades, five receptions, 81 yards. And the key reception of the ball game back and forth at six. Here's Testaverde. Looks right, and he is brought down. Tim Johnson got it. Four sacks for Penn State. And Miami takes the timeout. They have one left.
Testaverde wanted to go to the right to that quick out one more time, but the defensive back has the end of the end zone to help him out there. Testaverde could not throw the football, and it's Tim Johnson, number 55, with the sack. Quick timeout on the part of Testaverde. Heads up play with just 25 seconds left.
Timeouts remaining, and the time remaining in the battle for the national championship. Bratton scored first for Miami from a yard out. Schaefer then scored from a yard out, capping a 74-yard drive for Penn State. Mark Seelig with a 38-yard field goal. Then Dozier from 6 yards out. And that followed the Conlon interception that set up that touchdown. And by the way, Bill Hawkins' interception set up the Miami drive. So it is 14 to 10. And the countdown continues. Conlon stays in. 13-yard line. Third down and goal. Incomplete. Incomplete. Fourth down. National championship. a flag down at the 11-yard line. There are 9 seconds remaining. Penn State takes the ball back to the 5 on a personal foul. Spitting the distance to the goal line. The seventh grade is now 66-1. And Joe Paterno has won his 199th game. You can talk about numbers for the next week, but there's only one that counts, and that's number one.
It's an incredible football game by both teams, though. A storybook season for the University of Miami, coming in at 11-0, registering the first undefeated season the regular year on the part of the University of Miami. And now Penn State will undoubtedly be crowned the national champion.
Offensive guard for Penn State, Dan Morgan, at 6'6", 272 pounds. Every time we saw him this week, he said, say something about the offensive line. Say something about the offensive line. They were magnificent. Penn State was magnificent. And I think the Canes were also. It's just the way that it ought to be. It came down to the last minute of play for the national title. And Vinny Testaverde back at 4th and 6. And it could have been over several minutes ago.
Well, he showed a great deal of character as well, yeah. Bob, with 4th and 6, as you mentioned, throwing the football out to the Blades and then getting the first down and giving his team an opportunity to win the football game, and that's what he had to do, Bob.
I think you have to give credit to Joe Paterno and his staff for doing an outstanding job of shutting down Testaverde and winning the national championship.
Let's go down to Ahmad Rashad. Ahmad?
All right, we're here with Shane Dunn. Shane, you guys, you play, that's the way you win a national championship, right out there on the field.
Oh, exactly. They were talking about our defensive backs being too short. Man, they didn't want to catch the ball. They just came up and rocked them. That's the key to the game. They didn't want to catch the ball.
You guys wanted to go out and finish them, but it seems to me you kept them in 3rd and long all the time. How'd you do that?
It's just a great effort by our front people, just a great effort by the whole team. I mean, we knew we could beat them. We had it in our minds if we beat them all along, and we just took off and did it.
All right, here's good. Coach Paterno here. Coach. Congratulations, Coach. I just told Shane. Shane, this is the way you win a national championship, out on the field.
Well, I always hoped you would that way. I think our kids played a great game. They beat a great football team tonight. I think our defense played about as great a college football game as I've ever seen.
They were so persistent. They just destroyed the passing rhythm of mine.
Well, I think our defensive coaches did a super job getting the kids ready. And I came up with the big plays. They've done that now for 2 years. They're a great bunch of kids.
You've won a lot of big games, but this is the biggest one.
Well, it's one of the biggest ones, certainly. We've had a lot of luck in our life, and I have been fortunate to be around a lot of great young people and great coaches, and I just thank the good Lord for everything he's given me.
All right, congratulations, Coach. You guys are number one.
Well, I think so.
All right, back up to Bob Costas.
Ahmad, thank you very much. As we pointed out at the very beginning of the game, a year ago at the Orange Bowl, it was there for Joe Paterno and the Nittany Lions against Oklahoma. The Sooners beat them, and they became the national champions. A second chance exactly a year later, and Penn State capitalizes, upsetting Miami, which had been a touchdown favorite. The Nittany Lions have a second national championship. You remember they got one a few years ago with a Sugar Bowl victory to climax a big season with a win over Georgia that gave them the national championship on that occasion. This is the 100th season of Penn State football, and they celebrate that century of excellence with a national title tonight. Vinny Testaverde unofficially threw for 285 yards, but of course he had the five interceptions among seven Miami turnovers. What do they say about Schaefer? All he does is win. 66-1 since the seventh grade. Only the Orange Bowl loss last year against Oklahoma. Schaefer was just 5 of 16 for 53 yards, had one intercepted, but he comes out on the winning side. Penn State with the national championship, 14-10. We'll be back with more from Tempe, Arizona in just a moment.
You can say an orange is sweet and juicy and fun to eat. But there's one word that says all of that. And a lot more. Sunkissed. You have our word on it.
The Sunkissed outstanding players in tonight's ballgame. Shane Collin for Penn State with two interceptions and eight tackles. Alonzo Highsmith for Miami. 18 carries. He rushed for 119 yards. And each player will receive a special trophy in honor of his achievement in tonight's game. And Sunkist will donate $2,500 to the General Scholarship Fund of Penn State and Miami in their name. The final score, Penn State 14 and Miami 10. And I think it'll be said time and time again, the way to win the national championship is on the field like we have seen here.
Oh, I think so. I think this makes a big call to the NCAA for a national championship game to be played each and every year. They begin their convention this coming week in San Diego, and I think many people are saying, I hope they finally realize this is the way to win a national championship by playing on the field.
Well, again, defense wins championships, and we saw it here tonight. Two good defenses, and you got to give your credit to Joe Paterno and his staff for coming in and stopping Vinny Testaverde in that offense, stopping him cold, five interceptions and seven turnovers.
But I don't want the loss to be the end of the world for the Miami Canes. They had a great season. They had a tough time tonight against Penn State. And you know that ball club, and I understand they've got a couple of young quarterbacks that could be just as good as Vinny Testaverde.
Well, they are. They're a young ball club, and they'll be back. But I think what we talked about early, and that is Joe Paterno wanted to get inside of Testaverde's head, make him a little bit confused, get him rattled a little bit, and you had some problems, and it happened last year in the Sugar Bowl against Tennessee, and I think it happened here again this evening. Quarterback, when you're playing that style of defense, can't do it all himself.
What about Penn State? They just continue to do it.
They do. Penn State had 17 fifth-year seniors, and to a man, they said that we all decided to come back for our fifth year walking off the Orange Bowl field last year after being beaten by Oklahoma. They felt to a man that they could win a national championship, and they saw the dream come true tonight.
It has been the Sunkissed Fiesta Bowl, the final once again. It is Penn State, the national champion, defeating Miami by a score of 14-10. For Bob Greasy, Jimmy Cepelo, I'm Charlie Jones. Let's go to Bob Costas. Bob?
And all that remains now, Charlie, is to say goodnight. A national champion has been crowned, and that
football
championship belongs
thousands of games
to the Penn State Nittany Lions. John Schaefer heading off following the 14-10 victory. These are unofficial numbers, but in terms of total offense, Miami had 445 yards to just 152 for Penn State.
A season to remember is over now in college football. Thousands of games played, a few individuals honored, a new national champion crowned. But the curtain also comes down in a different sense tonight. We focus on the headliners and the pro prospects, and we forget that for many of these participants, it's the end of football. the end of an essentially youthful experience. They move on now to careers and responsibilities. Time passes, but the memories last.
This is the time to remember, 'cause it will not last forever. These are the days to hold on to, 'cause we won't, although we'll want to. This is the time, but time is gonna change. I know we gotta move somehow, but I don't wanna lose you now. This is the time.
Even after the bitter taste of this defeat fades away for Jimmy Johnson and for Vinny Testaverde, we hope they too will have fond memories of the experience of this college football season, a season which ends without a national title for them and with the national championship for Joe Paterno and the Nittany Lions of Penn State. We'll see you tomorrow at 12 Eastern Time with NFL 86 before the Browns-Jets game. So long from the Fiesta Bowl.
Promotional fee has been paid to NBC by United Airlines, serving 13 cities in Asia and the Pacific. United, a fresh breeze across the Pacific.
This has been a presentation of NBC Sports, proud to be the network of the 1988 Summer Olympic Games.